because you gave me game too. I don't know if you know, but you gave me game, real nigga to a real nigga. You feel me? And as far as the speak things into existence, fuck all that ifs and all of that doubt, and it just say what it is. And like you even said with the P shit, as far as being a master manipulator, basically, you feel me?
Bro, let me tell you something, man. And you could take this dude was so smart at what he did. He was like the perfect liar. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I always say he was like this illusionist, man, this magician, because, man, our albums wouldn't even be done. And he had one CD made, like one cover, and that thing package looked beautiful with no CD in it. And like, man, look, I watched this man make Walmart and Target update their sales from for Ghetto D. He turned to Target and he was like, okay, I see y'all doing 50,000, okay, for y'all stores in the United States. I tell you what, if you up it to 70,000, I give y'all 10% off. Dude from Walmart table said, hold on just 1 minute. Got on the phone, called back and said, okay, you give us 10% off, we'll do 75,000. Target came back and said, you give us 15% off, we'll do. He was going to always go down all the way to 20%, but he wanted to get all them above 100. When he was done, each Target and whatchamacallit had did 150 a piece, ordering that shit and paid for it. And look, he had the CD and he was telling them, look at this different. This ain't the clear CD. This colored is different. It's going to sit out in the stores. It's going to be the biggest record ever since Tupac records, Ice Cube and all this. And they like, well, they sold a lot of numbers and you're doing some numbers. And when he sat there and put that and unveiled that bitch and set that a presentation of it, them motherfuckers went to ordering, man. And I'm sitting there trying to hold my, because you should let me and C be in the meetings. Like, because I, you know, always wanted
you
to
knew what was
moments. You wanted to go, damn. And you, me and C calculating like 300,000 and this nigga get $9 a CD and they going to give him this check at party up front. Oh my Jesus, this nigga about to get $3 million. Bro. And I'll tell you this before I went off, the realest shit, and I don't fear nothing but my God, no man human, you know what I'm saying? You either gonna beat me, I'm gonna beat you, you can either kill me, or hopefully I don't have to kill you, you know what I'm saying? But, man, one of the most scariest moments for me, and it sounds crazy, you know, they used to give you a check back then, you wasn't sending nothing to no bank, you had to do a draft, they send you a check. He was like, go to Priority and pick up my check for, I think it was True to the Game album. And he got paid off what it was shipping already. And they gave me a check, man. And the motherfucker was like, for $4.2 million. I called him first. I left out the office and went in our office, bro. And it got on my knees like it was mine. Thank you, Lord. Like my hand was shaking, bro. My hand was shaking like just $4 million. I'm like,
hell yeah.
I'm sitting there like, man, oh shit, let me see. And he wasn't answering and finally coming back. And he was like, nothing. Hey, you got that? I said, yeah. I said, bro, it's $3 million. He was like, go get the calculator. I was supposed to get this. I'm like, yeah, it's right about right. He was like, all right. He said, look, you got the account number. Go walk to Wells Fargo's bank, which was a block away. That was the longest block. I want to write a movie about this shit. It was the longest block in life, bro. I'm walking and I nobody know what the fuck I got, but in my mind, everybody, because like everybody, you felt like everybody looking at me. And you know, you in LA, so you got a few gangbangers getting their hustle around there. And I'm like, bitch, if you touch me or talk to me, I can set up front, bitch, I'm gonna hit you and run. You know what I'm saying? Because I ain't gonna
you gotta run, fight, you can't sit there and fight.
Yeah, because bitch might come out of my pocket. Man, I might go to jail with this bitch. And he like, man, just call me when you get to the bank, man. And I'm like, I said, bro, I said, man, he said, don't bring your gun with you. Don't have that on you going in the bank. I'm like, bro, really? He said, man, sir, man, holler at me when you get to the bank. Like it was nothing. Bro, I'm walking, look like everybody looking at me. Motherfuckers, if motherfuckers spoke, I'm just mugging them like, bitch, don't speak to me. You know what I'm saying? And when I finally got in that bank and saw the cop that was working that bitch, I ain't never been so happy to see a policeman in my life. Like, bitch, I'm safe in this bitch now, right? We get in line and I see the actress that I've always was in love with, man. That was on The Young and the Restless, the black chick. Oh, what's her fucking name?
I know what you're talking about, though.
That beautiful motherfucker, man.
I know what you're talking about, though.
Her name was Priscilla on there or something. And I see her, dog, and I'm like, nah, I'm ready. She had the window right next to me. And I say, yeah, I need to put this $4 million check in. This ain't my money, man. Man, and the lady, she said, oh, okay. Oh, no limit? Okay, put it in there. And then when she fuck around, gave me the receipt. This was one of his accounts. I looked at the receipt and she was like, hey, how you doing? Nice meeting. You got the no limit chain on. And I'm like, I've been wanting to talk to her all my life, dog. We could have had a baby right then and there, man. I'd have went at it with her. Bruh. Yeah. I wasn't worrying about that, about her, man. And we had money, so it wasn't like this nigga got a bunch and we ain't got broke, shit. You know, right. He was taking care of us. But I'm still fucked up. And then when I look back as a man now, I'm like, no matter what all happened with us and we back close, we all talk, we cool. But, you know, we never not stopped. We just wasn't like most labels. We was too close as family. So when we went our ways, it was more or less like, damn, you going to do your thing? All right. And,
right.
But it's like I sit back and say, I had to fuck my bro that I know come from the project. He had more money than that as time went on. But I'm like, my bro had $230 million and it wasn't nothing to him, dog.
So what I was asking is, what the publishing look like? Like when you re-release your shit, is you good on that? Like, nigga that give everybody they publishing and all that shit.
This how our deal was. Our deal wasn't even paperwork. It was on some man street shit. He was like, you get all your publishing and we go 50-50. You know, nigga, when we met, Outkast was visiting Fiend, right? And Fiend was showing him all our houses. And they pulled over and Big Boy got out. And nigga, I'm out there and there's some funny shit. My wife, when I was married, man, she used to give a fuck about them roses and all that shit. So I'm out there clipping roses and shit. I'm supposed to be a gangster. I'm clipping roses. So I get up, I'm like, damn, Big Boy, what's happening? He was like, this you serve on? I said, yeah. He said, he looked at my house like, damn. He said, yo, y'all mad? I said, no, not yet. And he looked over and saw the cars. He was like, you help him out? Like, and he was like, man, what the fuck percentage y'all get? He was like, oh, we 50-50 and we keep our publishing. I'm over the look, and that's when I found out Outkast was sharing, them dudes were sharing 8%. And then they only got 25% of their publishing at that time. And even LL, when I found out what his contract was, 13% after all them years. And still didn't own all his publishing. See, P had this pride, right? I don't want you to ever say I owe you a motherfucking thing. So he would give you extra. My nigga, whenever, say your album was coming out, right? And I did 4 songs on your album with you, 4 verses, right? I'm always mm-hmm. there. We got paid for each verse I might have did on your album, $1,500 per verse. So if I was on 4 songs, nigga, that's $6,000. And we had 3 albums, 4 albums coming out a month. So I'm on everybody's shit, nigga. We was on there because of family. But then P was paying us, our apartment was free because he ain't want us in New Orleans. Then he was paying each of us $2,500 every 2 weeks to just be in the studio, to not be in the trouble. We was on payroll. And then when you turn your album in, nigga, if I was shipping 500,000, you got paid off of say 5 times 10, that was 5 million, right? And then when he take back, you know, he gonna recoup, it's a business. And what they gotta tell, you know, so whatever that number was left might be 3.2. You got half of that up front. You feel what I'm saying? And so but the way we were selling, I did my first album, $260,000 the first week. I paid everything back. So anything else of that was a plus. My one album that went number one, I did $397,000. You know what I'm saying? And then when you turn your shit in, and you know, even in his gift to you always was something different. Like my first album, he gave me the Corvette that I always wanted, right? And then my check. Second album was stocking this store that at one time Kmart was the biggest store, right? Mm-hmm. And it was such a small store called Walmart. And he gave a motherfucker like stock in Walmart. when Walmart was just getting popping. So my kids split the Walmart stock now. I've been at Walmart stock since 1998. You feel what I'm saying? And at first I was like, this thing give me stock to this shit. What the, you know what I'm saying? And but then he laughed because one of my dreams one day, honest to God, where it might sound crazy, I wanted to be a stockbroker, man. I saw a movie with the one with Michael Douglas back in the day, and I'm like, man, I want to go to New York and be a stockbroker. I used to read and knew the stocks.
It was like Wolf on Wall Street or something, right?
Yeah, it was, yeah, the original one.
Yeah.
You know, and so my second album, yeah, he gave me my check, you know what I'm saying? But he also gave me like, man, we fucking with Converse. That's when he brought Converse from a dollar stock when he got his tennis to about 19, and we all jumped out, you know, but he gave me stock in Converse and Walmart, like as a gift, you know, and you know what I'm saying? And, you know, he was that type of person, man. And even our houses, you know, like with Death Row, with Shug there, man, when you out Death Row, nigga, Charlotte, everything was, when Snoop came to us, he was in a Hummer that was in Shug name. You know, anything Pete gave us, it was in our name. You know what I'm saying? And the funny thing about it, my house, when he got a bunch of houses for everybody, I'm the one went to him, my second album was coming. I said, bro, I got a kid coming. Look, man, I want a house, bro. Whatever I got to pay, recoup it, bro. You can do that, man, or whatever. This apartment, cool. But I'm married now, and I got a house. And that nigga didn't just give me a house. This type of person he was. He had his faults, but this type is, his heart was 97% good. He had 3% fucked up shit, you know, he egotistical. But that nigga went, got, he bought it, and there was a new subdivision. He bought 20 houses in there, and that was all the artists where all of us live. And he gave it to us, nigga, in our name, and he furnished it out and then gave us an extra $50,000 to do whatever else we wanted to do, you know. And it was because I asked for a house, and he didn't want to just give me one and not all the other artists that were still on a lower tier level. Because now I was stepping up because of my second album. So I was getting up to a level beneath him and the Mysticals or whatever. And so he gave us that shit, man. And the funny part about it is, yo, MTV Cribs, man. And one day, I'm going to catch this dude. The guy that came with Joe Clare to do Rap City, P didn't want us to do the way they wanted to do it. They wanted us in the BNC Murder Rap City. They wanted us to do it on four-wheelers and take pictures for the Vibe cover with fatigues and in the hoods in the forest. And it's crazy shit. The dude, forgot his name, man. Whatever his name is, that Vibe magazine. We didn't take we took the pictures in the soldier shit, but because we didn't do what they wanted to do, he went to New Orleans. He had to do something, right? And he went and took a picture of the Hot Boys, and that's the first time you ever saw the Hot Boys on the cover, because didn't want us to do it on four-wheelers. So he had to do a Vibe cover and turn it in, and he went and took their picture, and that's how they ended up on Vibe. And people got to see who they were, and they were coming.
Who they actually were.
But I wanted to be different. I said, well, you come to my house. And Joe Clare was like, are you serious? So my house, because when I met Fat Joe, he was like, yo, that's your house? My house was the first house, like, rapper to put his house, like, on TV, meaning, you know, so when they, you know, they had the front and then the inside, and Joe Clare was in my car, and the guy that was shooting, his producer, got fired from BET, and they had so many questions, and people like, man, that was gangster, y'all went to his house, da-da-da-da-da, why he took that concept and went to MTV, and he's the one that's over MTV Cribs. He derived that from the ratings that came from me showing my house. Because see, Murder, I love him to death. Why C wanted to do his shit walking through a cemetery? Just, I don't know, man. But I did mine in my house. And I was one of the rappers that showed it. And that same guy took that concept because of the ratings and all of, you know, like, man, that was his house, man. Damn, oh, that's nice. That's crazy. Y'all was in his house and this and that. Show my cause. That man went to MTV when he got fired and pitched that show to them, MTV. And because I ran across Joe Clare one day, and he told me, you know, your house, he took that idea and went and did that. You know what I'm saying? So it's a lot, man. Yeah, P was a different animal, man. Like, you know, money wasn't, man. P was the type of person, bro. P drove around in a dually truck. You know what I'm saying? Real talk.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't, bro. He got a Rolls Royce because Priority gave it to him. He went and got a Ferrari because people was talking shit about Cash Money when they first got their money and they bought Ferraris and all that.
Motherfucker
took and bought everybody on our label sports cars and bought a Ferrari. And so he could ride up in New Orleans, let people see, nah, nigga, we still got this. And then he never drove that Ferrari again. Man, C. Murder used to take turns in Houston, taking that bitch out and riding the streets of Houston. All that shit you see now where he's showing the Rolls Royce on California, I guarantee that dude still will go get a rental car and ride around.
Yeah, that's some gangster shit. But that's you ain't gotta flash it when you really got it. That's some real shit.